Hey, how's it going, everybody? Welcome back to Soling the Ark, the beginner's guide on the island. All right, I hope you guys are having a great day. I'm having a really good day. All right, believe it or not, you know, I'm having a great time. Okay, I love this early part of the game. It is so cool. Uh-oh, raptor. Get out of here. All right, let me see. Raptor over there, and me that's stuck on a rock. Okay, so if there was, okay, and I'm stuck on a rock again. All right, that raptor's gonna come right up here. Okay, ah, there we are. Ah, there she blows. All right, they said I couldn't swallow that softball, but I proved them. All right, so you know, I'm going to make up a whole bunch of trake arrows because I think we're getting close to the time where we can start getting into taming stuff. And I've been out here. I've been hunting a few things. I've got a little bit of meat. I could get it spoiled up, and I probably should. But I need something that can help me harvest berries faster. Oh, wrong one. I need something that can help me harvest berries faster because it's just I can't keep up with how fast I'm growing with, you know, hand-picking the berries. So I need a trike, or I need something that can gather berries. And I'm thinking a trike or a stego or something, and I'm nowhere near high enough level for a stego. So I'm thinking a trike is the way we're going to have to do it, but I'm having a hard time finding a trike. So let's see. All right, that's all spread out. All right, now here's a little trick. With these bows, craft up two of them. One of them for regular arrows and one of them for trank arrows. So where you have one that always has trank arrows on it. So where you just switch from one, with that one right there, to another one. Bam, there's trank arrows. Yeah, it works. It works well. All right, and now I think that raptor took off. We're going to come over here. And we're going to go see. And I was able to kill a few of these Mega Nura, and I think I might try to keep killing a few of them, because I need their chitin. Where'd you go? Oh, you died way too fast. Where'd you go, dude? Oh, come on. Oh, really? Just a whole swarm of you guys. Just a gaggle. I can't even see where any of you guys went. Really? Huh. See, ground collider density. Alright, let's turn that sucker down, apply that, and let's see if we can see some of these guys. No. They're just lost. So I was looking for chitin, and yeah, I thought I would kill some bugs, but apparently, they decided they didn't want to give me any chitin. They'd eat me for a little bit. You know, they'd chew on my little morsely bits. But they didn't want to give up any chitin after I did all the work. Oh, here's one. Found one. Never mind. All right, so there's 23 chitin. I need cementing paste is what I need. One bounce all the way over here? No? Okay. Because with the distance I am away from the... I see any bugs up here? Bugs? Are you up here? All right, with the distance I am from the water, I need to craft some water reservoirs. So where I can collect some water. And that requires cementing paste. So I went ahead and I learned the cementing paste. Engram. It's not that hard. Let's see. And then also the water reservoir. So I can craft the water reservoir, but that also takes 5 cementing paste. Each cementing paste takes 4 keratin or chitin. So, and the only way to get keratin or chitin is from chitinous animals. And I'm also clearing out some of my stuff. And also, say if you kill something while you're holding a bow and it's pulled up like this, you can switch to another weapon. And it will not use up that arrow. See here, watch this. Let me harvest these guys real quick. Get back my stone arrows. Alright, say like this. Zero. Alright, say pull this all the way back. And you want to save this arrow? You just select another one. And it'll just keep that arrow. You won't use the arrow. Which is very good to know. Alright. Let's go over here. And I'm still looking for a trike, but I have yet to find one. I mean, I had that one that I had found. But it wandered off somewhere. I don't know where it went. It probably got eaten by the Spino. And that Spino, he's still down there harassing me. You know? There's another Dilo. Alright. And I don't want to tame that Dilo. Actually, you know what? Maybe I do want to tame that Dilo. Huh, are you a guy or a girl? You're a girl. A girl 140. Alright, he's running. It means that she's... See, like right here? I'm about to use this strength arrow. These are important at this level, so you just switch. And we have some meat, so we're just gonna throw it on her. Let her go. Alright. That's gonna be actually a pretty good tame. She can follow us around. And also, with these arrows that are sticking out of their face, if you just walk over them, walk over the arrows, you can get the arrows back. Alright, so let's see how she's gonna tame up. Yeah, she'll be our little buddy. She'll be our Lady Snarf. It's been a while since I had a Dilo companion. Yeah. Alright, so, yeah, she's gonna be, wow, she's going to tame up almost level 200. Her taming effectiveness is going to drop because we're not using prime meat, but I don't think it's going to drop that bad. All right, so yeah, I think she has enough meat on her, and we're going to go take a look, see what else we can find. Wow, a level 200 Dilo. You don't see that every day. All right. Oh, wow, we're that close to the redwood biome. Oh, and right down there is where those new, crocs are. Maybe I could get one of those early on. What level are those saddles? Let's see. Trike, Ichthy, Parasaur. Huh. I get a few new ones at level 25. I'm going to have to take a look. Because if I can get those that early on, that would be worth it to tame one of those. I didn't realize I was that close to the swamp. That's kind of cool, though. And the redwood biome? Eventually, I could go over and get a dire bear or something. That'd be pretty cool. I love dire bears. Dire bears are so fun. All right, well, I'm going to get this guy tamed up wherever I left her. Where did I leave you? Oh, here you is. All right, I'm going to get her tamed up. And then, yeah, I will bring you guys back. And you know what? We're going to go take a look. Close am I to, I'm almost level 25. Okay. Alright, so yeah, get her tamed up. I'll bring you guys back, and I'll see you guys in just a bit. See you then. And she's up. Alright, and we're just gonna go with Snarf on this. I like the name Snarf. I mean, they look like a Snarf. If anybody knows what a Snarf is, then, yeah. They look like a Snarf, especially when they have those, you know, when they flare out. Yeah, she tamed out at 198. I mean, it was just regular meat, so she lost a bunch of taming effectiveness. But you know what? She's got 262 melee damage and 936 health. So this is a winner. All right, she can hang out with us and be our buddy, you know, and do all sorts of cool stuff. We're going to put her on neutral for now, and she's going to follow us, and we're going to make our way back over to base for a little bit. Yeah, I can't believe that. That was kind of cool. All right, and when it comes down to taming up some of these dinosaurs, when you tame the carnivorous ones, they require meat or prime meat, but when it comes down to taming the herbivores, which I'm going to do here in just a few minutes, it requires berries, mesoberries specifically, if you don't have the kibble. All right, now kibble is something you have to grow. You have to make from eggs and from crops that you grow. So in order to get the best taming effectiveness, you need to have eggs, which this girl right here is going to give us, and then we also need, just chill out right there, girl, and we also need the crops grown. So we're gonna get those going eventually, because those are a very important thing, is getting the crops going. All right, let's get some more narcotics. It's 7. All right, let's just clear out some of this stuff. And eventually, we're going to want to start saving some of these seeds. Because we're going to want to plant them in our crops. Or in crop lots that we will be making. Let's grab this stone. All right, stone. Cementing paste. Hey, 8 cementing paste. What are we lacking? We're probably just lacking stone because it requires a lot. Each one takes a bunch. So you know what? And then for all these berries I've just been throwing away, Snarf is going to hold on to most of them. Because now, see, look at this. All right. Her inventory, see, if I take this meat away from her, it's 6 minutes 42 seconds. Put it on her, all right, 26 minutes. All right. So she's almost like times 5, the spoiling timer. So we're going to take all these berries that we've just been throwing away that I don't really feel good about just throwing away and leaving on the ground. And, you know, that one right there can go away, though. But these is right here, because we might need these for taming, or we might need them for water when we're out and about. So, yeah, so she can be right below her encumbrance level, and then we're doing a lot better now. So that's how we're going to do that. And then now, also, we're going to come out here with, let me show you something. We're going to craft up, actually, let me go whip up some stuff, and then I will be right back, because we're going to make the irrigation stuff. We're going to make a tap, we're going to make a couple water reservoirs, and we're just basically just going to make like a small little water tower that we can expand on, that we can use to get water so we don't have to run back down to water source down where the Spino is. And yeah, so we can just take care of ourselves that way. So let me grab some of these rocks, and I will bring you guys back here in just a little bit, all right? So I'll see you guys then. All right, we got another little female that just decided it wanted to wander into our area. All right, we'll see if, yeah, there we go. All right. So let's grab the rest of this one's meat. Come here, Snarf. I'm gonna need your meat. All right, I will get you more meat, okay? Let's get you some hit points for now. And let's go over and let's throw this one on this wherever you went, because there you are. And this is another female. So hey, you know what? We're building up a pack of dillos. So, and I saw a parasaur over here that I think I'm going to go over and... Oh, there's a dodo. Hey, I'll take a dodo. Eventually, I'm going to want to tame up a whole ton of dodos. This one's a male, so I don't care about you. Yeah, later, dude. All right, so I'm going to use the pick on this guy so I can get as much meat as I possibly can. All right. But if I see another parasaur, I'm going to end up ganking that guy, getting his meats, getting his bits, so I can feed my... soon-to-be Dillo army. I don't really normally start out with a bunch of Dillos, but you know what? If Dillos are going to offer themselves unto me, then I will not question that. So keep your eyes out for a parasaur. Oh, yes. What is this stuff? Oh, this is just seeds. They haven't spoiled yet. All right. Let's stick that in there. That in there. Go with that. I only need 2. And we're going to save the rest of that stuff. But we're going to get this cementing paste. And then we're going to start making up a couple water reservoirs. And then we're going to get the rest of that going. Because we need 2 of them. Because one of them only hold a certain amount of water. And when that water's used up, then you have to wait for it to rain. And I'd rather not have to... Where'd you go? Where are you? Oh, there you is. All right. Okay, yeah. She'll be taming up. All right. Okay, and and keep your eye out for parasaurs and trikes. That's what we're looking for. Parasaurs and trikes. And yeah, also, just so you know, when you're taming up dinosaurs, all right, see, look at this. This bottom bar right here, she's going to tame up here pretty soon. The bar, the purple bar that says unconscious, all right, when that starts going down when you tame them, all right, and then the bottom bar, the taming meter, whenever they eat whatever food you put on them to get them to eat, it'll slowly go up, all right, but the goal is to get the bottom bar full before the top bar gets empty. Now, as you as they are going and they're just sitting there, their torpor is slowly going down. And the way that you stop the torpor from going down is you add narco berries or narcotics. And yeah, we're just gonna call this Dilo 2. All right, there you go, dude. All right, I'm gonna take back some of this meat. I'm gonna put it on Lady Snarf. You keep that. And yeah, all right, so come on, dude.
Yeah.
All right, you're a female, so you're going to give us eggs as well. All right, come on. I'll park you right up on here. There you go. All right, so... Oh, there's a parasaur. Can I get your meats, dude? What level are you? Oh, level 15? Oh, yeah. I didn't want to craft a slingshot, I swear. Now, here's also one of the easiest things. With bolas, when you take bolas, you can throw them at dinos like this. Usually the smaller dinos. And they can't go anywhere. So now, we can come up to it at our leisure and just kill. And the bola lasts between 10 and 15 seconds, I believe. So, this way here, we don't have to waste anything. Basically, it's just the only chance of our spear breaking. Is it. Alright, so I'm gonna use the axe on this guy. Get as much meat as I can. And then... Or get as much hide as I can. And then whatever meat there is, I'm just gonna split it up between the two, dillos. Yeah. Alright, let me grab some stone. So I can make the rest of that stuff. Dude. All right. You know, and I didn't want to make this sling. You know, I can make the slingshot. That way there it tells me exactly how much stone I have on hand. All right, make two reservoirs. And reservoirs, they will only snap to these pipes, okay? So what you want to do is you want to make, I'd probably go with the straight pipe first. Where's the straight pipe? Straight pipe right there. Let's go with one of those, and then one of these intersections, and then also we're going to want a tap. And a tap takes wood, so we're going to want to go get some of that wood really quick. All right, come here. Go grab some wood. Alright. Grabbed up a tap. Alright, now we're gonna want the water to come into our house. Okay? So... How we're going to start off with this is we're going to start off with a straight pipe down on the bottom. All right, right like this. And we're going to want the pipe to come right through like this. Okay, let's get in the middle. Let's come out a little bit. That's about as far as it'll go. So let's get it lined up. All right, let's go like that. Okay, now we can take and we can put a tap right there on the end. Okay, and then now we take... And we make another straight pipe. Oh, let's go out here. Let's take a look. It might be way out here, so we might have to... Yeah, okay. This is perfect. All right, make another straight pipe. So where it comes out a little bit farther away from the house. And then a vertical pipe. Okay, now watch this. A straight pipe. Not like that. Vertical pipe. That's where it goes up. And then, take this. Goes like that. And then we just pop our water reservoirs right to that. One there. And one there. Now, as those fill up, and it, since I can't get very close, you can't really see it. Oh, here they are, right there. See, they hold 200 water, all right? Now, if you go like this, this will tell you exactly how much water they really hold. You can hold 100 water, and this exact same amount. So that holds 200 water each time it rains, all right? And then when it rains, we can go in, they'll fill up, and so we'll have a combined of 400 water. We'll be able to drink from it four times between each time that it rains. Now, eventually, when we do crops, we're going to want to run water from down there at the water source all the way up here, or have probably about 8 to 10 of these filling up the water, because that's how much it'll take. It takes a lot. Or you make metal ones, and the metal ones will hold, I believe, 300 or 400, maybe 600, something like that. We'll probably craft one just to so I can tell you exactly how much they hold. But yeah. And that's how you do that. Yeah, now, next time it rains, we'll have water in the house. We don't have it now. But, yeah, and then you can just come right up here, and then you can just drink from this. It's quite effective. Yeah. All right. And as I find more chitin and stuff, I'm definitely going to be adding more of that stuff to it. Hey, Snarf, you leveled up already. All right, good job. All right, we're going to get her up in levels as quick as we can, because she's going to go out hunting with us. We're going to get her up to, thinking about 3,000 hit points, seeing just how effective a level 200 Dilo can be hunting with right next to you. Yeah, I think she'll be pretty good. All right. So we got the water set up. We got the Dillos tamed. We have the cementing paste made, but I think that's going to do it for this episode. So, hey, I hope you liked the episode. If you liked the episode, click that like button. I really appreciate that. All right, and so until tomorrow, this is Flinger Foo, and take it easy, everyone.